everyone, and welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you're new. My name is Abby, nice to meet you. If you aren't new to my channel, if you've been here for a while, you will notice that I have a new background. I completely cleaned my room so that I can have a couple new backgrounds for my videos. I actually redid my Disney background. This is a background. My bed is going to be a background, and also my desk over in that corner could be a background, but here is my dresser. Anyway, I am just making a short little video today. I am actually home from work today. I was supposed to go, but had to stay home because of a family emergency. What else is new with my life? So I decided to take advantage of that, take advantage of the fact that I already had my makeup done because I did it for work, but then I ended up not going in for work. Might as well make a video. Today, I'm gonna be telling you guys some really embarrassing stories from when I was like middle school age, between like 11 and 13. I think most of them are from like when I was 11 though. So yeah, I think that's middle school age. That was grade 6 for me. So this was almost 15 years ago for me. But I digress. Some of them are kind of funny and I thought that you guys might enjoy it. So let's get started. The first embarrassing thing that I did when I was in middle school was me and my best friend Lauren, we had a crush on a couple of guys in our classes. There was like a group of boys that hung out that literally everybody referred to them as the boys. There's only like 4 or 5 of them, but they were the boys. This is so embarrassing. So something that you should know about me, especially in like middle school and stuff, I literally never had a pencil or a pen to write with. Never. And if I was given one, it was gone within probably 30 minutes, like lost. I don't know where it went, it's gone. But there was a few pencils that I did not lose because I would ask one of the boys for a pencil, and when they gave it to me, I would stash it away and I wouldn't give it back. I was a creepy little 11-year-old who really had a crush on these boys. So I decided that I should have their pencils, I guess, was my thought process. I don't know. But I would very often go to my best friend and be like, I stole Greg's pencil. Like, what? Why? Yeah, so that was one weird thing that I did as a middle schooler. Creepy, I know. One thing that happened, I'm pretty sure this was grade 6 or it was grade 7. One of my friends, let's call her Sarah. One of my friends, Sarah, was dating one of the boys, like from the boys group. And every day at recess, they would like hold hands on the playground and walk around and they'd kiss and like they thought they were like the coolest because, you know, they were in a relationship in 6th grade, which I guess was considered cool. I don't know if this was 6th or 7th grade. It may have been 7th grade, I don't know. But we thought that these two were going to get married. Like, we were like, they're in love. They're gonna get married one day. And then when they broke up in like grade 8, it was like all hell broke loose. But anyways, one of these days, we were all hanging out by a tree in the playground we called Bob. There was also Bob Jr., which I think was actually bigger than Bob. Which doesn't make sense. Either way, we were hanging out by Bob. This was what we did very often during recess. We would just hang out by Bob and talk and hang off the tree and stuff. So one day there was a group of us just hanging out by Bob. Sarah and her boyfriend were just sitting there holding hands, being a couple. And somehow the topic came up when, I'm just gonna use Greg as an example. They were saying that like Greg didn't have like the balls to have a girlfriend or like hold any girl's hand or kiss a girl. Like, I don't really understand what the argument was. Like, they were saying that he didn't like have the balls to do it and he was saying that he did. And then the one guy was just like, yeah, well, I dare you to hold Abby's hand. And then he did. And I was just standing there like, when was this decided? I don't think I was here. But we were sitting there holding hands and I was just like, dead ass, like, had a crush on Greg. Never told him. But that was literally me with every single guy I had a crush on in elementary school or middle school. Like, I like you. Never gonna tell you because you won't like me back because I was hideous. And then he let go of my hand and then Sarah's boyfriend was like, oh man, you did it. And then they like all walked away. Me and Lauren were left standing by Bob and she just kind of looked at me and was like, what just happened? And then confused me just standing there, I'm just like, I don't know. And this was like a big deal. It was such a big deal that we like talked about it for like weeks. We still talk about it sometimes. One thing that we also talked about very often after it happened, God, I have to think of so many fake names. Okay, I'm just gonna start using our Riverdale and Archie comic character names because it's just easier. So I also like a guy named Jughead. Sure, Jughead. We were playing soccer during gym one day. We were outside playing soccer. By the way, not a sporty person. Like, please do not try to get me to play sports. I won't do well. I will not try. It's a bad idea. So we were playing soccer. I was kind of participating. Like, you know, you're like jogging and the ball gets near you and you're like, oh God. But I was like kind of jogging like you do in gym class when you don't want to participate. And Jughead is in front of me. The ball goes near Jughead. Jughead kicks the ball, and where does it go? My face. Jughead kicked the ball, and it hit me square in the face. And this is where the embarrassing part kicks in. First of all, I just stood there. Jughead immediately is like, oh my God, are you okay? Like, I am so sorry. Are you okay? And I'm like, yeah, I'm okay. And he's like, oh, and he like kind of goes to hug me. And so I thought he was gonna hug me, and I was like, Jughead's gonna hug me. And like, I was 100% smiling on the outside. Like, and then he didn't hug me. And Lauren and I had talked about that for a really long time afterwards. We were like, oh my God, he almost hugged you. Because to us, an almost hug was just as good as a real one. The next two things are definitely going to paint me into a negative light. I was not the nicest kid growing up. Well, actually, I was pretty nice like in young elementary school, like when I was really little, especially because I was like this tiny, underweight, little blonde girl, kind of looked like the girl from Poltergeist. I should put a comparison picture of me and the kid from Poltergeist. Like, we kind of look alike. I was super sweet, super little, like the shortest kid in the class. I was always in the very front of the class pictures because I was short and I was underweight and I was just tiny. So I got picked on a lot by like random boys, or even like there was this one girl who like tormented me in elementary school, and I would just like go up to my brother at school and just be like, yeah, Zach so-and-so just called me an idiot. And then my brother, because he's my older brother, would go up and just kick the shit out of whichever kid it was. Even the girl who tormented me, he did beat her up. I do remember that. Once middle school came around, I knew I didn't have like my brothers around, so I kind of like got the balls to be an asshole to people myself so that they'd leave me the fuck alone. You know what I mean? So I was definitely not the nice girl, especially once Lauren and I became friends. We were kind of assholes. Like, big assholes. So we didn't really have cliques at our elementary school and middle school either. It was kind of just like the regular kids and the, I'm just gonna call them losers for this video, like the ones who weren't considered cool. And so like all of us would kind of be like, ugh. I was part of like the regular kids group, and there was a bunch of us girls that would hang out all the time, and we were all super close, especially because the majority of us grew up together. Like, we went from kindergarten up until this point to school together. Up until like grade 8, the majority, like 99% of the people in my class were people that were also in my kindergarten class. And so this particular group of friends, we would hang out after school, and one of the things that we thought was really fun to do was hack people's MSN accounts. MSN was an instant messenger, and I don't know like what kids, do kids nowadays do instant messenger, like WhatsApp? But it was just on the computer. Like a Facebook Messenger, but just for, I don't really know. What would you even compare it to nowadays? I don't know. We had MSN. There was also AIM, but I only had MSN and Yahoo Messenger, where I used to go into chat rooms when I was really young and I would lie about my age, and that's a whole other story. Oh God. So we would guess the passwords of the people in our class, go onto their MSN, talk to people as them, and kind of make people pissed at them. There was one girl in particular, we knew that she liked a guy in our class, let's name him Jeremy. So we knew that she liked Jeremy, so when we were trying to guess her password, the immediate first thing that we guessed was, I love Jeremy. And lo and behold, that was her MSN password. Oh god. So we got onto her MSN and started messaging Jeremy and a bunch of other people as her. And then she ended up being sick the next day, so she didn't come to school, but everybody just thought that she was like too scared to come to school because of what she said on MSN. And then when she came back to school, people were yelling at her, and oh my god. Now, I feel horrible for doing the things that we did, but back then, we all thought it was funny, and we were a bunch of buttholes. What can I say? Like, honestly, we were just mean. I don't know what else to say. We were mean kids. And then another mean thing that we would do, well, actually, it's not really mean. Well, I mean, the one maybe was. But we used to also sit around after school, after being on MSN, and we would prank call random numbers for like an hour. The one time we called somebody, I don't know what we said, but we hung up, obviously, because during a prank call, you're not gonna like finish out a conversation. We said whatever, we hung up. They called back to the house. Then my friend Zoe, her mom answered the phone, and the person who called back said that we prank called her. And then she said that we would never do that, and that the lady was being like ridiculous, and yeah, we definitely lied to her mom and said that we were not doing any prank calls and that lady was just being a bitch. One prank call that we did, this is gonna sound so ridiculous, we had a friend, let's call her Alicia. Alicia had a younger sister. And Lauren and I thought it would be funny if we like prank called her younger sister. So we put on like her younger sister was like 5 at the time. We put on like a child's voice and called, asked for her little sister. Let's call her Dana. We asked for Dana with the little girl's voice. They asked who it was, so I said it was like Emily from school. So they gave Dana the phone and we were talking to her as if we were like this like 5-year-old. But we thought it was hilarious that she genuinely thought it was Emily from school. And we were like, do you want to come play? She's like, yeah, where? Like, the park. Like, why were we the way we were? I don't know. The very last story I'm going to tell you also includes said friend Alicia. It is the most ridiculous thing you'll literally ever hear in your entire life. Oh my god. Again, pretty sure this happened when we were in grade 6, so I was 11 years old. We noticed that me and Lauren were waiting for Alicia before school because like we'd always show up like 5 to 10 minutes early and then hang out outside and then go in when the bell rang. So we were sitting there waiting for Alicia because she lived beside the school. We could see her house from the school. So we were just like sitting there waiting, watching. And another thing we used to do is we used to like go up to the fence beside her house and like yell at her from the playground so that she'd know that we were there so she could come down and like hang out with us at school, you know what I mean? Anyway, Alicia was running late. We see her come out. She gets over to us and she's like, my mom's gonna kill me. We were like, why? She's like, I had a dream that I had sex and now I'm pregnant. Oh god. And for some reason, our 11-year-old minds, like, we knew that like she couldn't get pregnant from a dream, but we were like, hey, like she's acting like she's pregnant from this dream, so like it must be real. Like, we were like, is it real? Like, can you get pregnant from it? Like, you can't get pregnant from a dream. That's ridiculous. And then her mom came outside and was just like, Alicia! And so she had to go back. Lauren, the bell rang. Lauren and I looked at each other. We're like, oh my god, her mom knows that she's pregnant. She's gonna die. Pretty sure her mom was just calling her over because she, like, forgot her lunch or something. But we were dead set that her dream actually did get her pregnant and her mom somehow found out and she was going home. That was the last time we were ever gonna see her because she was dead. I probably have like 300 more stories to tell you guys. Like, so many things happened, especially like in my grade 6 year. Like, that was a year. That was a year. Oh my gosh, totally should tell you about in grade 7. There's this person, we called them like the person with the emails because they were sending these emails and nobody knew who they were. They were sending them to everybody in the class and like it was the weirdest thing. Maybe I should do a story time on that. If you guys wanna see that, let me know. It was super weird. I don't even know how to explain it. Either way, I hope that you guys enjoyed these stories. If you did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. if you're my age, around my age, even a little younger or older than me, did you guys do anything weird in elementary or middle school? Let me know in the comments down below. If you did like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you're not already. Also follow all of my social media that is listed down below. Same with my Discord channel, which you should probably join. We have some fun times over there on occasion, so like maybe that's a good reason to join. I don't know. I'm not gonna force you, but maybe you should join. Anyways, guys, I love you so much, and I will see you on the next one. Bye!